as well. I think there's a feeling that workers are weak at the moment and they can have a go at us and cut our terms and conditions. Our council is trying to cut £5 million a year from our conditions of service, are particularly attacking low-paid women workers by trying to introduce flat rate working for weekend working, for bank holiday working, and for overtime working, which means that the care staff that care for our elderly and disabled members of society are really at the heart of those attacks. And most of those low-paid women are facing about a 13% pay cut because of those attacks on their terms and conditions. It's ironic that Councillor Mackay, who's the chair of our staffing committee, I think is quoted in a press release this week having a go at the union, saying that we would rather see cuts in jobs and service cuts in jobs and services rather than cuts in our bloated service conditions. And you know, the reality is, as I say, it's low-paid workers that will face the brunt of those attacks. And ironically, he is a part-time councillor, gets more money in his councillor allowances than those care workers would get if they were working a 37-hour week. I would say to these councillors, you know, to talk about us preferring to lose jobs, show us any jobs that you'll keep if we cut our service conditions. There's no question of them keeping jobs. This council is cutting back and it's privatising because its only real aim is to cut the council tax and to trumpet the cutting.
The welfare reform bill is going through Parliament. We'll see, according to government's proposals, 1/5 of expenditure on benefits and tax credits for people of working age cut. 20% cut in income for everyone aged 16 to 65. So all this is linked to the pension issue and linked to the thing. If you think the pensions aren't going to be there, if you think support states for the states are not going to be there, it's not. They're taking it all away. They are trying to abolish the whole settlement that took place in 1948. It was established by our grandfathers and great-grandfathers when they came back from the Second World War and refused to tolerate the return to the 1930s. They are treating to abolish that settlement in a united, ongoing fightback for all the trade unions, my own included, from here on in. Thank you.
Thank you.